Wind turbines are a crucial component of the renewable energy supply. Once installed, they typically provide an electric power of 2 to 3 megawatts each on a windy day. Wind forces the blades in a rotational motion. This movement then is converted to electric power by a generator that is located at the very top within the nacelle. The vibrating forces acting on the whole system are transferred through the base plate into the earth, where these ground motions can be measured by seismometers. Wind turbines often are installed at exposed positions, which naturally are off-site anthropogenic infrastructure in many cases. However, the environment of those sites may already be used by permanently installed sensitive seismometers to measure tiny movements of the Earth's surface, like earthquakes or earth tides. Because of the growing number of wind turbines, a large percentage of seismometer stations in Germany have to face this conflict. To allow a permanent coexistence of both applications, understanding how wind turbines emit seismic waves is necessary. Hello and welcome. In this video, I would like to introduce you to the topic of seismic waves that are radiated by moving wind turbines. You will learn how a typical wind turbine is constructed and to which movements it is excited by the power of wind. How do wind turbines influence seismic measurements? Moreover, how do the signals decay with distance from the turbine? These questions I will be answering by discussing observed frequency spectra of wind turbines and the amplitude decay of their seismic emissions with distance. I will do this using research findings of Toni Zieger, who is working on this topic in the framework of the research project TREMARC, which analyzes objective criteria for vibration and sound emissions of onshore wind turbines. To measure seismic signals emitted from wind turbines, Toni and his colleagues installed temporary seismic stations of the Karlsruhe broadband array, KABA, near Landau in the Upper Rheingraben. There, four wind parks are in operation. You see them on this figure indicated with red crosses. Seismic stations record ground motions and appear as green triangles. This is a recording of the ground velocity at station TMO57 on a windy day with wind speeds of up to 70 km per hour. You can see the ground motion over time. But are these signals related to wind turbines, or is it just anthropogenic noise like traffic and industry, or is it a distant earthquake? To find out, the geophysicists compared seismic signals of windy and calm days. This is a seismogram of a day with wind speeds below 10 km per hour. The signal amplitudes are lower by a factor of 5 to 10 compared to the previous example. Apparently, wind activity couples to the subsurface and increases the ground motion. This may be due to trees and other vegetation that bend in the wind or the movements of wind turbines. First, I show you the effect of the rotating blades. Here, the geophysicists again measured seismic signals on a windy day. But now they had the opportunity to do this while the wind turbine had a break and the blades were not rotating. Then the turbines were activated and the blades began to move. You can see the effect on the ground motion very clearly. Hence, when the blades start rotating, ground motions are induced. Such seismic data can be analyzed quantitatively by transforming it into the frequency domain. This is a plot of the power spectral density of data recorded at a seismometer near the wind park in the neighborhood of Landau during 1 month. The differently colored lines correspond to different rotation speeds and thus different levels of wind activity. Blue stands for low speeds and calm conditions, while cyan colors indicate high rotation speeds at windy periods. You see that the power spectral density increases with increasing rotation speed. For higher wind activities, specific oscillation frequencies are excited at 1.8, 3.6, 4.5 and 5.4 Hz, all multiples of 0.9. Those amplifications obviously result from a turbine in one of the nearby wind parks. Other wind-dependent sources are far more distant and therefore can be ruled out. To understand the influence of the wind turbines on seismometers, the question now arises what components of the turbine are the source of these vibrations. Is it only the blades passing the tower as indicated in the previous measurement, or is the oscillation of the tower itself responsible also? Wind turbines consist of a tower with a nacelle on the very top. This is the place where the generator is located, which is connected via a gearing mechanism to typically three plates. The tower is mounted on a base plate with diameters of 20 to 30 meters and a depth of up to 4 meters. The mass of this structure of steel and concrete can reach 3,500 tons and couples the wind turbine to the subsurface. To find the origin of the oscillation frequencies, a model calculation of a tower was set up. Using the elastic properties of the material, the natural frequencies were calculated. They are shown here in color-coded deformation. The fundamental mode shows largest movements at the top of the tower with one oscillation node at the bottom. Higher modes have multiple maxima and nodes. For example, the first overtone here or the second here. The interaction of those normal modes with the blade passing can explain the observed frequencies or spectral lines in the spectrum. However, a clear distinction between both effects together with the propagation behavior will be the object of future analyses. The amplified spectral lines are close to each other and may overlay other weak seismic signals like earthquakes or earth tides that should be recorded by permanent sensitive seismometers. Practically, it is not possible to remove the disturbing emissions of the wind turbines easily from the seismogram to obtain an undisturbed signal. However, one possibility to reduce wind disturbances is to place wind turbines away from permanent seismometers. So, Toni Zieger and his colleagues set up another measurement experiment to study the spatial damping of the excited signals. They built up a line of temporary seismometers straight away from a wind turbine to study the seismic attenuation of the waves traveling through the subsurface. The results of this experiment can be seen here. Shown is the power spectral density of the first frequency peak at 1.8 Hz with respect to the distance from the wind turbines. The further away the measurement, the lower the signal of the wind park. A line fitting the measurement is shown in blue. It indicates that at the soft sediments of the upper Rheingraben, the signal amplitude decays with 1 over the distance r to the power of 0.84. That means, at a distance of 3 km, the signal amplitude is only 14% compared to measurement at 300 meters distance. Studies at other wind turbines and different soil properties show a similar behavior. The exponent b, however, depends on the local site conditions. In this example from the Black Forest, the subsurface consists of hard rock. Here, the estimated exponent is around 0.38. Compared to the example from the Upper Rheingraben, the signal decays more slowly, to only 42% at a tenfold distance. In this video, I showed you the seismic signals that are emitted of wind turbines. They can be measured by sensitive seismometers and may overlay other signals of interest, such as earthquakes or earth tides. You learned that the blade passing as well as the normal mode of the nacelle tower system of the wind turbines induce ground motions. As other seismic signals, the seismic emissions of wind turbines decay with distance. On a soft sediment in a tenfold distance, the amplitudes may have decreased to 14%, while on hard rock, 42% may be preserved. Thus, with a certain distance in between, wind turbines and seismometers may operate in peaceful coexistence.